Hello everyone, so today we are gonna see a game played between Wesley So and Lee Quang Liêm. And Wesley So was white and he opened the game with e4, and Lee, who was black, went e5. White went knight f3, knight c6, bishop b5, the Rilo pace, a6, bishop a4, knight to f6, and castle. Bishop e7 was played, and then rook e1. And our very serious threat is to take this knight, take, and then pick this pawn up. Pick this pawn. So yeah, that's why b5 is played to avoid this. And white brings his bishop back. And here, two main moves are there: castle. But this was not played in the game. But d6 was played. White here went c3. The main idea of this opening is to put your bishop on c2 and use it on this diagonal, bishop c2, d4, and yeah, put pressure here. Black here went castle, and h3 was played to avoid any bishop g4 idea spinning this, because this bishop is not there to come here and protect the knight. So that's why here black went bishop b7, now aiming to kind of put pressure on this e4 pawn, so that becomes a little tough for white to go d4 immediately, because maybe d3 has to be played protecting this pawn. So white here immediately went d4, not dealing. Black went rook e8 and knight g5, putting pressure on this pawn. And black just brought his rook back, and white went back knight f3. Black brought his rook to e8 again, and it was thought that Wesley So will repeat with knight g5, but yeah, he went knight b d2, and black went bishop f8. a4 was played, kind of the structure is very solid, so breaking it. Black took this pawn, white took back, and h6 was played, stopping any knight g5 ideas, because there is no rook coming here protecting. Rook e7, pieces become very passive. And here white went bishop c2. Now I'm focusing down this diagonal. Black went knight b4 and bishop b1, keeping the bishop pair. Black here went c5. And now black has a nice pawn structure. White went d5 here, making this bishop passive, and black can have ideas of bringing this bishop on this diagonal. Black here went knight d6, ideas of knight d6 and knight c4 probably. Rook a3 was played, maybe bringing the rook, or if move the knight possible, and then bring it to the g3 square, putting a lot of pressure. And in the game, that was a very important idea. Black here went c4, and white got this very nice square, d4 square. Now it is controlling some very nice squares. Black went queen f6 and knight df3 was played. Black went knight to c5 and white went b3 and knight bd3 was played. White took knight into and went rook e3. Because this rook is kind of blocked, so this rook wants to come to the square. Black went b4 and white went rook a1. Knight e5. White took and black took with the pawn, and the position is roundabout even. White here went knight f5 and c3 was played. White getting little better here after rook f3. And Queen d8 was played, which resulted as a very big blunder. Can you find the winning move for white? Yes, it is knight into h6. Because if you move the king here, this is actually just lost, because I'll just take with my rook, pinning the king. My knight is protecting. You cannot take. Next move, I'm bringing in my queen, and that is completely lost, because this square is also controlled. So I'll just bring, and maybe you just get checkmated in a few moves. So So that's when black took this knight, and this is lost because after rook g3, you move your king anywhere, maybe bishop g7, still you defend, but you're just losing the piece, and your king is too weak. My queen enters and is gone already. White is clearly winning. But after rook g3, leave and king h7, because, and now this is gone because after queen g4, only surviving move is queen g5, but you have to give up your queen, and checkmate is just very near. That is lost. So how do you defend this checkmate? There's no way you can defend. Only queen g5 is the only way, and if you try to bring your bishop out controlling the square, the problem is this square is now undefended. And in this position, Lee resigned the game. Thank you for watching the video.